My colleagues used an outdated language. They have discovered suddenly that they are falling in love with Syria. After fighting Syria, eclipsing its role and its legitimate revendications for quite some time. But you know, love makes miracles. Their language reminded me of the era of Lawrence of Arabia. These people still think, and they are wrong, that the international relationships have freezed at the time of Lawrence of Arabia, and these relationships did not evolve anymore since that era I'm talking about. They have discovered also the importance of the Arab League as a regional organization, while they have ignored the Arab League's decisions and resolutions and stances on the Arab-Israeli conflict and the Palestinian question for decades. More importantly, ladies and gentlemen, some of these ambassadors who have been entrusted by the so-called international community to maintain peace and security in the world, through their important role in the Security Council, have chosen to undermine peace and security in the world, following their narrow strategic and geopolitical interests. They destroyed more than a country through their influential mechanisms in the Security Council. Actually, they used the Security Council to destabilize many countries. They did it on Iraq, they did it on Libya, they did it on Ivory Coast, they did it on many countries. The important part of these gentlemen is that they are talking about my country without consulting us, without sharing with us their concerns, their remarks. They think that Syria doesn't exist, it doesn't have an ambassador here, and that we are still under their hegemony, and they deal with us as if we are a former colony that we should subjugate ourselves to their will. They are wrong, and they will be disappointed. I think the Europeans and the Americans are still repeating the same mistakes. Syria will not be Libya. Syria will not be Iraq. Syria will not be Somalia. Syria will not be a failing state. Syria will deal with them equally. Equally. Instructions and orders came from overseas to Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and some others in order to move against Syria in the United Nations. The French ambassador has just referred to you when one of your distinguished journalists asked him about the Arab League. He said, this United Nations is about states, and that the Arab League is about states. Well, very well. After saying that, he doesn't deal with Syria as a member state. He deals with us through a draft resolution elaborated by some people in the Arab League. For us, this Arab League maneuver, we are not part of it. And we will not allow anybody to speak on our own behalf. What we have to say, we will say it publicly, blatantly. We will not ask the French ambassador to speak on our own behalf. We will not allow the British ambassador, neither the American ambassador, to come in here and speak about our own future. They cannot ignore the will of our own people. Since this is the United Nations, since this organization is about states, then stop following YouTube's rumors. Stop building a false arsenal of information that is aiming at misleading the international organization, the international community, and the media. The media. Gentlemen, this is very important, your role. You are an eyewitnesses in this international organization. Before I give you the floor, I would like to remind you of one fact. 2 months ago, on a political program aired by Al Jazeera, by a journalist named Faisal Al-Qasim. And that program goes back to before sending the Arab Observers mission. Even before sending the Arab Observers mission, in that political program, there were two guests. The current Tunisian president and a Syrian political analyst. That journalist, Faisal Al-Qasim, who was running the show, told the Tunisian president, he wasn't already president at that time, he was just a guest in the studio, he told him the following. Don't ask me my sources. I have credible information coming from Doha, and they were in Doha. You know, Al Jazeera headquarters in Doha, in Qatar. I have credible information from Doha that the Syrian regime will be over on the 22nd of January. That was said, gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, 2 months before, from now, 2 months ago, before even the Arab Observers mission went to Syria. Then you all remember that the Qatari Prime Minister came in here without any mandate from the Arab League. He met with Ban Ki-moon and he asked him to make pressure on the Council so that the Council will address an invitation to the Arab League Secretary General as well as to himself, the Prime Minister of Qatar, to come and address the Council on Syria. When the Qatari Prime Minister did it, the Arab missions observers were on the ground. They were working on the ground. He didn't even wait until the final report was issued. Why I'm saying all this? I'm saying all these details because everybody knows that everything which is taking place right now in these deliberations was concocted in advance in order to harm the image of Syria and the interest of Syria. An Arab League that cannot even protect its own report. Is it really worth it to represent Syrian voices in the Security Council? This Arab League couldn't even respect its own report, the report of the observers. And you know what? Some of you know very well that the Arab League sent a compilation of documents to the Secretary General, asking him to distribute it to the Security Council members. But somehow the Arab League Secretary General forgot to attach the report of General al-Dabi so that the members of the council are not aware of the content of this report. It's by mistake, inadvertently, in good English. I'm in your hands.
نزار. سعادة السفير، طبعا ما هي تحفظاتكم على مشروع القرار المقدم من قبل فرنسا والمغرب كما فهمنا؟ السفير الفرنسي تحدث عن أن ليس هناك حظر للسلاح أو مشروع لتغيير النظام، هل ترون في ذلك صحة؟
نحن ضد أي مشروع قرار يقدم عن سوريا إلى مجلس الأمن بدون التشاور مع الحكومة السورية وبعيدا عن خطة العمل العربية القديمة المرتبطة بتوقيع البروتوكول. نحن نتعامل مع الجامعة العربية على أساس البروتوكول. إذا أرادوا إدخال تفاهمات جديدة فينبغي أن نتفق عليها، نحن والجامعة، ليس الجامعة ومجلس الأمن في غياب سوريا.
هل تفكرون باتخاذ خطوة مضادة حيال الجامعة العربية، كمثلا الانسحاب من الجامعة أو أي خطوة مشابهة؟
نحن ملتزمون بنجاح مهمة المبعوثين العرب، ولذلك وافقنا على التمديد لمدة شهر لهؤلاء المراقبين، لكن الجامعة لا تحترم نفسها ولا تحترم مهمة المراقبين، فهي نقلت الملف إلى مجلس الأمن قبل انتهاء مهمة بعثة المراقبين العرب.